Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel with a new series of Let Us Learn Computer. In the last video, I have told you about MS Word, and that is about Home tab I have discussed, and we have covered font menu. So now we are moving to the next topic, that is paragraph. This area, this box you can see in front of you, this is about paragraph setting. Okay, so let us move ahead. Here you can see I have typed one paragraph. Okay, now you want to make some changes, some editing. How we will do, I will show you. Here like this heading I have written report, but this should come in center. I want this to come in center, but by default what is coming, all are just coming from the left to right. That is a common way of writing, from left to right. But sometimes we need heading to come in the center. So here you can see the 1, 2 and 3 and 4. These four option you can see. Here you can see it is going from left to right. Then you can see the center. Then from right to left. And this is justify. So these are the four options which is known as for the alignment, which we are going to work today. So first here you can see from left to right, that is the common by default it is selected. But I want this word to come in center. For this what we have to do is, we have to select this word and just we have to click on this. Now it is in the center. As it is selected, if I will put enter directly, the cursor will come in center. But now I don't want things to come in center, so again I can go back to another alignment. Okay, now again you can come down here, you can see this also. If you want to bring in center, you can select and bring this into center. If you want to reduce the space, you can use backspace option and then you can bring this into the center. Okay, so this much is clear, I hope. Alignment, right? Here you can see this alignment is for right to left. So the cursor, now you can see whatever I will write will start from the, though it will go to left, but it will start from the right side. Okay, so this is another option. And the fourth one which you can see is justify. Now it is equally, both the margins will be left and it will be equally distributed. This is for the justify. Okay, I hope this alignment is clear. All the four options you can see I am changing. Here you can see the difference. If the alignment is center, the lines are coming in center. If it is like this, it will complete like this. So we'll come to the common thing, what is the correct way, that is left to right. Okay, so this much is over, that is alignment of the text. Next you can see just next to this line spacing. Now if I want to want a more difference between these lines, more space I want, so what I have to do is I have to go and I have to select. Like this, by default it is 1.15, that is the standard spacing. If I am making this 3, you can see how much space. Sometimes we need to leave space. Suppose we need to leave a blank space for writing the answers or something. So we can apply, increase the size. Okay, like this we can increase the size between the lines. Or you can see between the paragraphs also. Okay, between the paragraphs also we can give space with the help of this option. Now the next option is, you can see the color is there. So this is very easily, you can just select this. We have done in the font menu also, you can select this and you can color this. Like this it can be highlighted. Okay, like this we can go. So this is a way how we can highlight about the font and all. This was done in the previous video already. So this 5 options we have done. Okay, alignment, different types of alignments, and the spacing between the lines and paragraphs, and the coloring, background shading. Now the next option you can see, it's another very important option. It is about the borders. Okay, sometimes we need to put a line just below this paragraph, or both the sides, upper below also and upper side also, so we can use this. Okay, you can see this bottom border. If I am putting my cursor here and I am applying bottom border, you can see just below that line has come. Then again I can come down. Why this blue color? Because the blue color is already selected under the borders and shading. By default it is selected, that is why blue is coming. Now again, if I want a particular line to be covered after this topic also, I'll just go this and go there and bottom line. Okay, bottom border. Now sometimes we need to have the upper side also, okay, above the line, above this topic. If I want the line, so what I will do, I will click here and I will just select top border. You can see just above the cursor, border is there. Okay, so like this we can apply the borders. With the help of Control Z, I have removed that border. So this is bottom border I have shown you, top border, left border. Okay, so left border I also we can apply here, the cursor I am putting, and left border you can see. Right border also we can apply the same way, right border. So in this format you can see, after putting all the borders from all the four sides, a structure will be formed like a rectangle. Okay, even sometimes we can form a table also, like you can see I can form a table like this, but still this is not looking nice. As well as you can see, the above options are changed. You can see here even the tab is changed. We were working on home tab, and the tab now it is highlighted as design. It means that this table and all are just actually they belong to the design tab. Okay, so this designing and all we are using different tabs. So again we'll come back to home tab and just we can remove this. Okay, now these are the different types of tables and border. If we need, we can use this also. Inside border, inside this line, outside border, like this you can apply different types of border. All border, like if I am selecting this and I'm applying all border, so what will happen, you can see all the four sides will be covered. See, the box is framed. Okay, if we want to border a particular name or a particular heading, we can use this. So I hope this border is clear. Very important. Now this is about the text border, border around the paragraph or the headings. Now if you want to have a border for the whole page, so we will go to this particular option is there. Just to this drop down arrow you click, and the last option, borders and shading. We were talking about borders right now, so we will select page border. In the page border, this whole page will be covered. So variety of, you can see box, shadow, 3D, customized variety of designs will be there. Now 3D is there. In this you can choose a different color, like I have chosen this. You can even change the width, and even you can have a variety of designs, okay, available. So like this I have selected, apply to, you can apply to whole document or a particular paragraph also. So a whole document is selected, okay. You can see a beautiful border is available now in front of you. Okay, so like this we can apply a variety of borders as per our requirement. Okay, so I hope this is clear, all the different types of borders are clear. Now we'll move ahead. You can see here above, you can just see here, these are known as bullets for writing this numbering anything. These are known as bullets for writing. So we can do one thing, just if I am here and these numbers are not available, imagine these numbers are not available, then what I can do, I'll just click here, I will press enter, and I will go this particular option given here, and I will select the bullet is given here. I can type, I can enter, and just go write the points I want to mention, like I have written, and again you can put enter, again you can put enter, and you can use like this. Okay, so this is about the bullets. Similar way we can use numbering. Okay, like one is there, you can write and put enter, and you can have like this, you can write. So these are the different ways to apply bullets and numbering. Apart from this, sometimes we need to write in a way like a main heading, then subheading, and the more further subdivisions are there. For this we can apply, different options are given. For this, how I can show you is, you come down. Okay, so here what I will do, suppose I have written a question here, something I have written, and I have press enter, then again tab, or I have written something, enter, again tab, or something is written, enter, and then I have written something. So like this, if I have writing question and then sub question, something is written like this, you can apply here the variety of options. Like this I have applied. So here you can see automatically, this is one, the major question, then the sub questions under this, and then again major question, again I have to click tab, and I can write. So like this you can apply multiple types of bullets and numbering. So this is the way how we can apply the numbering. Now we can come down and I will show you more options. Here we can close this borders and all what we selected, top and below border. Okay, now the next option you can see, this option is for the shift indent, like the whole paragraph is written. I will show you, like this paragraph is written. Now what I will do, you can see the difference. If I am clicking on this, it is shifting little on one side, it is working like a tab, and if I am clicking it, this is going to the right side. So these two things are working like a tab. When we are using the tab option only, it is working with a particular word, one line or one word. But here the whole paragraph, if I want to shift all together, so just I have to click on this, and then if other way you can click on this. This is one option to increase or decrease the indent. So now we have covered all these five options of the top. Now you can see A to Z is written. This is very interesting, or we can say very comfortable. It makes our work comfortable. Suppose I have written here different names I am writing. Like I have written Rohit, and like this I am writing. Okay, so you can see different names I have written of my class students. Okay, so like this we can write. Okay, so names are written, but I want these people to be in order, a particular order I want. Now I have to work on ABCD, I have to select. So what I will do, just I will select the text, and I have to go to this option, the whole selected paragraph. We have to sort out the text in which order. I can make order of Z to A or A to Z. So we want in ascending order, that is A to Z. Just select ascending and it will be applied, and okay, you can see easily within seconds we can just get it sorted out into alphabetical order. So this option is used for alphabetical order as well. We can use this for the numbering, right? So these are the different options we can use for the paragraph setting, which will help you. You just practice this and it will be very much helpful to you. Thank you.